kids, like, think back. If you wanted to see, like, a rooster or a chicken, mm-hmm. you were either going to a farm, right?
Right. Mm-hmm.
Or you're watching Foghorn Leghorn Saturday mornings. Local food movement has changed all that in a big way, with urban chickens ruling the roost.
It's along this quiet street in Western Springs. Neighbors report the strangest sound.
People don't know what to think. Gracie is always the first one out.
Yep. They all have names.
That is Autumn. That's Moon. And this is Annabelle right here, the white one.
For the Tandys, this flock isn't some anonymous livestock, but family members.
I mean, it's not like a normal suburban thing to do to have chickens, I suppose. But yeah, it's been fun.
Annie Tandy has, in a way, become the mother hen of this backyard chicken movement.
We started with four. And now we're the test case for allowing up to eight.
6 years ago, the village of Western Springs joined the thousands of other municipalities across the country handing out permits for hens. A month later, Tandy's two kids came home to four fluffy fowlings.
They held the chicks right from the day we got them. Come on, come on. We feed them from our hands.
One day while working on her kid activity resource website, My Kid List, Tandy posted about her urban chickens.
Just giving my family the experience of raising chickens, you know, from chicks up to chickens in the yard and getting the fresh eggs. Oh, we got four. I think it's a great choice.
And that's about when coops started popping up in backyards all over town.
No, it was really surprising and very cool.
The beginning of a homegrown chicken movement.
Yeah, we were on a text chain. We should just name ourselves the Mother Cluckers.
The feathered family members, they lay about four eggs a day and a lot of tousled mulch around the yard. And if you need to round them up, you better be armed with a big bag of mealworms.
It's a feast. The pecking order is a real thing. She doesn't get much.
According to the USDA, there has been a 300% increase in backyard chickens as more families look for ways to connect with nature and their food source. For the Tandys, it's been a great experience, but the journey ends with hens.
Roosters are now allowed in the town.
Welcome news to the neighbors still trying to figure out those funny noises coming from down the block.
All right, 4 o'clock gang, this is not just a movement, but a poultry cult. These
what?
Are photos of chicken tutus that you can buy on Etsy and Amazon. And check this out. You think those coops in Western Springs were nice? Some people are building posh coops like this. A velvet chase and chandelier.
That's got to be at the North Shore. People
no,
in Western Springs don't do that.
Yeah, I'm done with that.
I'm telling you, they're all over. Now, obviously, yeah. The Tandys are keeping it pretty simple, but if you go online, you can go down a rabbit hole, or a chicken hole in this case, and see all this stuff. It is just absolutely crazy.
Wow. And these
ladies. Oh, I forgot.
There's a magazine.
There's magazines.
Yeah, there's
so I thought, you know what? There's got to be some kind of thing. There's five chicken magazines. The Chicken Whisperer. There's
oh my gosh.
Poultry in your backyard.
I'm a Chicken Whisperer. You get me on that grill?
Practical poultry. You know what? But that speaks to the fact that this is such a big trend. I mean, when you could go to a newsstand and find five magazines on chickens alone.
Yeah.
So just to recap, Time and Newsweek are struggling, but Chicken Whisperer magazine is
economists going down, all of it.
Yeah, and viewers may not have noticed, but you were nowhere near the chickens anywhere in that.
Yeah, why was that?
Why weren't you there?
I got a little bit of a bird issue.
A lot of bird phobia.
Maybe a lot of bird issue.